Hello everyone, this is the part 3 of unit 1. In this we are going to study about dosage calculation and remaining concepts. So dosage calculation, so this particular dosage calculation is defined as, called as posology. Posology is nothing but the study of dose of drugs. So the doses of the drugs are studied under posology. So what are the different types of doses and what is a dose? Dose is the appropriate amount of concentration or appropriate amount or concentration of a drug needed to produce a certain degree of response. That is called as dose. For example, let us take an aspirin which has several activities like antipyretic, analgesic and antiplatelet effects. So if the aspirin have to show some analgesic and antipyretic activity, then it should have a dose of 300 to 600 mg per day. And the same aspirin, if it have to show anti-inflammatory effect, then it should be administered at a dose of 3 to 5 gram per day. Whereas antiplatelet dose of an aspirin is only 75 mg per day. So that is dose. There are different types of doses. They are standard dose, means they are applicable for the drugs with wide safety margin. So they have a specific dose beyond which there will be unsafe, the drugs will be unsafe. Say example, oral contraceptives, penicillins, chloroquine, mebendazole, amantadine, they have a standard dose. And target level dose, which is non-measurable response. We don't know how much response is going to produce. But we'll give some amount of drug to the patient when we'll try to monitor, frequently monitor the particular patient for its actions. Example, antidepressants, anti-epileptics, digoxin, lithium and theophyllins. Regulated dose means accurately adjusted by repeated measurements, means the response is measurable. For example, hypertension. In hypertension, antihypertensives are given to decrease the hypertension to 120 by 80 normal value. Even in the same time, in the same way, hypoglycemics. Hypoglycemics means the drugs which are used in diabetes to bring down the sugar levels normal. So again here, there is a dose, a regulated dose, which are accurately adjusted to have a measurable response. Titrated dose. Titration means we'll have two types of titrations, downward titration or upward titration. So downward titration means in the very first dose there will be higher doses, then gradually reduce it to lower dose and then completely stop the medication. That is called a titrated dose. Downward titration, it is used in critical situations like trauma, some critical situations. Example is prednisolone, steroids. Whereas an upward titration means it is a non-critical situation. Usually used in non-critical situations where we'll use a smaller dose, starting dose at a smaller levels, and then we'll increase the dose levels. So that is upward titration. Examples like levodopa or anti-cancer drugs. Next one is prophylactic dose. Prophylaxis means before attaining a disease, we are taking the particular drug. Means before. Before attack or before infection, we are using that particular drug called as prophylactic treatment. Example, vitamin B complex. Therapeutic dose. Therapeutic dose means given during the treatment. Example, vitamin B6 for peripheral neuritis. Toxic dose are lethal dose. Lethal dose or toxic dose means those at which the drug produces toxic effects, dangerous effects. Call it as toxic dose or lethal dose. Coming to methods of calculation. So how we are going to calculate the dose of the drug? Drug based on the individual body weight or body surface area. So these are the two methods useful in calculating drugs for pediatric medications and antineoplastic medications. Also, as well as for the low body weight or those who are obese patients, means normal, other than normal elders, I mean normal adults. So we are calculating the dose by using body weight and body surface area. And we must remember a point that before calculating a dose, we must convert all the units into single system. Example, if the medication is supplied in milligrams and the drug ordered is in grams, then we have to convert everything into mg, or grams to mg. So here, based on the body weight, here we have formulas. So here we have formulas for individual dose by using Clark's formula. So body weight by 70 into average adult dose. So that is for individual adult. Whereas child dose, it is used for determining children. So it is weight in pounds by 150, weight should be in pounds by 150 into average adult dose. So that is the calculation by body weight. And next, body surface area, Clark's formula for body surface area. So that is body surface area means in meter square by 1.7 into average adult dose. 1.7 means average normal body surface of an adult, and BSA is calculated in the given formula as body weight in kgs to the power of 0.425 into height to the power of 0.725 into 0.007184. So that is the calculation for body surface area. Age, by means of age, calculation of dose by means of age, we are using Young's formula, Dilling's formula and Freid's formula. Age is used to, the dose is calculated for children. So here, child dose is equal to age in years by age in years plus 12 into average adult dose. This Young's formula is suitable to calculate the dose for children below 12 years. So here we can see 12, age in years by age in years plus 12. 12 means Young's formula, that is below the 12 years. We should remember that below the 12 years of children must be used, dose calculation must be used by done by Young's formula. So there should be age in years by age in years plus 12 into average adult dose. That is the Young's formula. Coming to Dilling's formula. Dilling's formula is age in years by 20 into average adult dose. And it is used for the calculated between 12 to 20 years. The children between 12 to 20 years. So here 20 represents it is below the 20 years of age. Okay, Dilling's formula. And Freid's formula. Freid's formula is age in months by 150 into average adult dose. So this is used for infants, months babies or infants. So here we have some other calculations for dose. So we'll see the nursing implications later. Nursing implications also here. So how do we calculate doses for different types of dosage routes? For example, oral. For oral, we need to calculate dose desired by dose on hand is equal to amount to give. So if we need to amount to give, we need to know means that dose desired. For example, if a patient is, I mean, if a patient asks, if a patient is intended to give 30 mg, but we have 100 mg, then what amount we need to give to that particular patient? So the result will give us the amount to administer orally. And this is also for oral. Dose decided by dose on hand into quantity, how many times we have to give, that is equal to amount to give. And for parenteral, dose desired on hand into quantity of solution is equal to amount to give. So that is for parenteral. So you can practice problems. So here, infusions, IV infusions. So IV infusions, amount to infuse, whether it is a 1 liter or 500 ml or 200 ml, that is, and per hour rate. Hour rate means 1 hour, 10 ml per hour, or some 20 ml per hour, like that. So hour rate is equal to number of hours, means how much time we need to infuse, that we can calculate. So amount to infuse by infusion time is equal to ml per hours. So we can calculate the hour rate. This is hour rate, and this is number of hours we can infuse the amount. So amount to infuse by infusion time is gives us rate of infusion. And next, ZTT factor. ZTT factor means drop from the saline bottle. Each drop we call it as ZTT, denoted as ZTT. So total ml by minute, time, number of minutes is equal to ZTT per minute. Or we also calculate like ml per hour. Here we are calculating ml per hour. So ml per hour by 60 gives us ml per minute. So that is for IV infusion. And of course, for pediatrics, we are using different formulas. And for safe administration, a registered nurse must double check the calculated doses with another registered nurse. If there is any outside the usual range, then we should call healthcare provider or a doctor. So for heparin, digoxin, or insulin, chemotherapeutic drugs, we should check with another nurse before administration. Coming to Indian pharmacopoeia and legal issues. So, what is Indian pharmacopoeia? Most of the countries, government of most of the countries has established their own standards, because the drug and its action also differs from the population, type of population, and the geographical position. So based on the population, type of population, and geographical position, every government adopts some sort of standards. They are published in Pharmacopoeia. Pharmacopoeia, which is the official textbook published by government agencies, which contains title, dose, formula, and molecular weight, description, category, solubility, standards, identification, limits for impurities, drug standardization assays, bioequivalence assay and bioassay, and storage. These are all present in the Indian pharmacopoeia. So, various pharmacopoeias. IP means Indian pharmacopoeia or international pharmacopoeia. BP means British pharmacopoeia. BPC means British Pharmaceutical Codex, which contains codes. USP means United States Pharmacopoeia. USSRP means United States of Soviet Russian Pharmacopoeia. and NFI means National Formulary of India. So how the drugs are controlled in India? Analytical agencies means which are standardizes the drugs, like Central Drug Laboratory Calcutta, which is present in Calcutta, and State Drug Control Lab, which is present in every state. Executive agencies like drug inspectors and drug controllers. Advisory agencies like Pharmacy Council of India and Drug Technical Advisory Board. So Drug Act and Laws. So the objectives of Drug Act is Act and Rules are to provide health to everyone. Eliminate quack doctors. Quack doctors means they used to say they have treatment without any medicine or without any surgery. We can treat anything, we can treat everyone, we can treat any sort of disease. They are called as quack doctors. So we need to eliminate such type of quack doctors. Quack medicines. Quack medicines means, like, for example, tantras, roots, some sort of folkware medicines which are said to have some activity but it is not proved. So they are called as quack medicines. And next one is adulterated drugs, means which are with some duplicate drugs or some adulterated drugs. And substandard drugs means which are not standardized by our Indian government or any standard companies. They are called as substandard drugs. And quality of drug. So that is also to maintain the quality of drug, we have some drug acts and rules. Everyone must follow those rules to maintain above things. So what are the acts and rules? So the acts and rules. So first one is Opium Act in which was given in 1878, which defines about different types of rules and regulations on opium. The next one is Poisons Act in 1919, Dangerous Drugs Act in 1930, import of drugs means importing drugs from other countries bill in 1937, Drugs and Cosmetic Act in 1940, Drugs and Cosmetics Rules by Indian 1945, Import and Exports Control Act in 1947, Drugs Control Act in 1950, Drugs and Magic Remedies Act in 1954, Medicinal and Toilet Preparations Act in 1955, Dangerous Drug Import and Export and Transshipment Rules in 1957, Drug Price Control Order, DPCO, we call it as DPCO, in 1966, Insecticides Act in 1968, Medical Termination of Pregnancy Act in 1971, and Narcotic and Psychotropic Substance Act in 1985, Consumer Protection Act in 1986. So coming to rational use of drugs. Rational use of medicine requires the patient receive medications appropriate to their clinical needs in doses that meet their individual requirements for an adequate period of time and at a lowest cost to them and their community. So what is the rational use means? Patient should receive medication. For example, if a patient has fever and he should receive medication for fever and associated ailments, but not a dump of drugs. He should not get so dump of drugs, and they should meet individual requirements, like whether it is child or pediatric or geriatric or adult, and adequate period of time. For only some period of time, like 5 days or 6 days or 10 days or 2 days or 1 day, like that. And lowest cost means it should be affordable by any sort of community. Irrational use of medicines is a major problem worldwide. So WHO estimates more than half of all medicines are prescribed and dispensed are sold inappropriately. Then that half of all patients fail them taking correctly. The overuse and underuse and misuse of medicines results in wastage of scarce resources and widespread of health hazards. So examples of irrational use of drugs is using of too many medicines per patient, polypharmacy, inappropriate use of antimicrobials. We should not use antimicrobials without any prescription, because we will get antimicrobial resistance. So overuse of injections, when oral formulations are present, even then we are using injections means, so that is also irrational. And failure to prescribe in accordance with the clinical guidelines. So every prescriber must follow clinical guidelines. If it is failed, then it is irrational use of drugs. Inappropriate self-medication, opposite to the prescription, often off prescription only medicines. So usually patients will go and ask medications in pharmacy. They'll take some drugs and they use those drugs. So that is called as self-medication. And non-adherence to dosing regimens. So doctors will say take twice daily, before food and after food, like that. Dosing regimens will be given by the prescriber or the registered nurse. Then the patients will not adhere to that particular thing. This also comes under irrational use of drugs. So who gives faulty interventions to promote rational use? So for that, we must have established a multidisciplinary national body to control or coordinate policies of medical use. And next one, doctor or prescriber must follow clinical guidelines. And next, a country must know, must use essential medicines list. And there should be committees, drug and therapeutic committee in districts and hospitals to monitor rationality of drug use. Inclusion of problem-based pharmacotherapy training in undergraduate curricula. Continuing in-service medical education as a licensure requirement. So we must take CME for our continuation of nursing licenses or medical licenses. Supervision and auditing and feedback must be taken by patients, healthcare providers. Use of independent medication, information of medicines, public education about medicines. We have very pivotal role in this particular public education about medicines. Avoidance of perverse financial incentives means medical representatives will give some perks, the companies will offer some perks to the healthcare providers to prescribe their drug. So such things are called as perverse financial incentives. We should avoid that. Use of appropriate and enforced regulation. Sufficient government expenditure to ensure availability of medicines as well as staff to monitor them. Coming to principles of therapeutics. Principles of therapeutics means it has some rights of administration. So they are medication, right medication, right dose, right time, right route, right patient, and right documentation. Here we have medication, right patient, right route, right dosage, right time, and right documentation. So healthcare providers must be sure that the drug is correct medication for the patient. So that is right medication and right patient. The right patient means the healthcare provider gives the right drug to the right patient or not. We must ensure the armband, their name, their IP number or their OP number, etc. Route. Healthcare provider must determine the proper route to administer the drug in order to have proper efficacy. Dosage. Healthcare provider must have the dose, proper idea on the dose before performing any drug calculations. Time. Time specified in the drug order may be given a half hour before or after the stated time depending on the policy of the hospital. Documentation. We should make sure to write the time and any remarks on the chart correctly. So these are all the principles of therapeutics. So by this we have completed unit 1. Thank you for listening, and we'll meet in the unit 2, chemotherapy.